I've made a copy of ODB 59, and I'm calling this one ODB 60, add current date. To add in the current date, it's a little tricky. Let's first look at how to add the dates into a table. So I'm going to go into my tables and edit my employee table. We're going to add in the date entered. And let's change the value of this to date and time timestamp. Now I'll add in just the date only. We'll make this a date. And then we'll also add in the time only. And we'll make this a time. Let's save this and close this window. Now I'm going to open up the SQL, going into Tools, SQL, and we're going to enter in some SQL to show how to insert the current date using SQL. Here's our SQL. We're going to insert into the employees table the last name and first name. Those were required fields. Then we've got the date entered, date only, and time only. To insert the current time in our timestamp, we're using current timestamp. To insert into the date only, current date, and the time, current time. Selecting all this and pasting into our SQL command window. Executing that shows we successfully executed it. I'll close this and open up our table. Going over to the right, we see our person, Jack Johnson the first. He's inserted at 7:11 at 7:50 a.m. So that works. Going back into our tools, SQL. Here I've got some other SQL. This time, we're just going to put current timestamp into the date, the time, and the date entered. So we can just put in current timestamp for all three. Pasting in here and executing shows that it successfully executed. Opening up our employee table shows that works just the same. Now our problem comes in on our form. We want to add in the current date when we add a new record. I'm going to edit our add a new employee. Coming up to our end date, I'm going to hold down Control and click on the box there. Right click, open up the control, and it looks like I didn't add in the spin button, the repeat, or the drop down. Those have no effect on what we're talking about, but I'm just adding them in for looks. What I want to show here is at the default date, we already know if we type in current timestamp, that would put in the current time. If I try and type that in, nothing happens. So there's our issue. We could try and add it in as a text box. Looking back at our SQL, our Jack Johnson is in quotes. Our current timestamp is not in quotes. So if we try and add this in with a text box, LibreOffice is going to put quotes around it and won't allow us to put in current timestamp. We could try and put it in as a numeric field, which does not use those quotes, but that won't work for the same reason this date does not work. It won't allow characters in that field. So there's no way to do this from a form. I'm going to save this just to save the drop-down box that I added and close. How we're going to get around this is, let's go back into our tables, table employees, edit. The only one I want is the date entered. I'm going to take this off. And our time, delete that. There is a way to do this for adding a new record. I'm going over to Tools, SQL, and what we're going to use is the alter command. We're going to alter the table employees, altering the column date entered, setting the default to current timestamp. Select all that, copy, paste, and execute. Successfully executed. Now when we go to our forms, let's add a new record. Let's add our new record. I'll make this Jack Johnson III and just hit save record. Closing. Going back into our tables, opening up our employee table. Shows we've got Jack Johnson III, and the date entered is 7/11/14 at 7:58 a.m. It would be nice to have a value that we could put on our form that would update the timestamp every time that record was updated. So every time our employee record was updated, we could have a last updated as well as a date entered. But unfortunately, there is not one at this time for LibreOffice. Maybe some creative programmer will write an extension for LibreOffice to do that, to update a field with the current date every time that record is updated. Until that extension gets created, there's ways to do it with macros, but we're not using them in this tutorial series.